Some of the world's leading international basketball minds held a coaching clinic in Marikina just a few days ago. Let's watch this.
We are here in the Marikina Sports Center for the World Hoops Clinic, where hundreds of basketball coaches attended to learn and to extend their knowledge about the game. This is the first of its kind in the Philippines, headed by Coach Tab Baldwin and a core of international coaches, where the European style of play was incorporated to our Philippine coaches.
This is a clinic where we have international coaches coming to speak to our local coaches, Philippine coaches from all over the country, and really trying to broaden their knowledge about things that aren't typical here in the Philippines, typical in the way of coaching, because we brought a very strong international coaching flavor.
Baldwin is no stranger to international basketball. He led New Zealand to its highest FIBA ranking of number 4 in 2004. But Coach Tab is more known to Filipinos as the former Gilas Pilipinas coach and the current head coach of the Ateneo Blue Eagles. Together with Coach Tab are other great basketball minds from various parts of the world, like Spaniard coach Nacho Lezcano, Baldwin's former player in New Zealand, Pero Cameron, and the head coach of the Lebanon national team, Nenad Vucinic.
I think this is just another opportunity to hear a different voice, you know, experience from different parts of the world, because I've coached in New Zealand for a long time and I coached in Europe as well. So it's an opportunity just to expand, you know, a little bit of our knowledge to Filipino coaches.
The country has improved vastly in its basketball program, gaining many achievements in the international game. That's why our local coaches are eager to learn in order for their players to quickly improve. Just like Roddy Santos, who gained multiple championships in the professional ranks under Coach Tim Cohn, Santos admits he is new to the coaching scene and wants to learn more.
Iba pa rin yung naglalaro ka sa nagko-coach ka na. So, yung fundamentals, yung how to teach your players, how to deal with your players, how to run a team. Marami pa, kaya very interesting talaga.
Not only the experienced coaches attended the clinic, all sorts of teachers were welcomed. And the ones who want to make a big difference in their community are free to do so. Ginny, a former player of the UP Lady Maroons and teammate of Sports in Action host Bea Daez, is just starting in this kind of field.
2 years ago, nag-start lang ako dito sa Marikina to help the Marikina community. Gusto ko lang i-share yung knowledge ko po. So sana may ma-develop kaming players dito sa Marikina para mag-start na mag-grow yung environment ng sports dito sa Marikina.
In basketball, it is important to never stop learning. Just like players who give it their all during practice, it should start with coaches that are always ready to learn.
For more on the World Hoops Clinic, we're now joined in the studio by coaches Nacho Lezcano from Spain and Pero Cameron of New Zealand. Coaches, welcome to the Philippines and welcome to Game Time.
Thank you very much.
Coach Pero, I just want to ask first, what did you guys teach during the clinic?
We taught all sorts of aspects of the game. Two things I talked about was being undersized as a big man and also rebounding. Mm-hmm.
Can you say, Coach, that is your specialty?
I don't know if it's my specialty, but I was always undersized as a player. Mm-hmm. And you have to fight in a different way, mm-hmm. a different style to compete with the bigger players, mm-hmm. To gain some sort of advantage, mm-hmm. because they have advantage of size on you.
Mm-hmm. For us Filipinos, Coach Pero, I think, you know, we're really undersized by nature, because we're not so gifted with height and size. But then what can you advise about on the players who are undersized, especially when they play the big man position, how they should fight against, you know, how they should play against bigger players?
Yeah, there's all sorts of defenses. It's mainly defensive end you have to adjust to marking the bigger player. At the offensive end, you can use your speed and your skills, but defensively guarding the big man, you must prevent him catching the ball where he wants to catch it, where mm-hmm. he can score, mm-hmm. and also make it tough for him to score when he has the ball. Mm-hmm. And you could use a number of different styles and tricks and techniques to stop him. Mm-hmm. You know, you can take away his dribble, you can put him in different parts of the floor to where he doesn't want to catch the ball. Mm-hmm. It's all sorts of ways. Mm-hmm.
All sorts of experience also for Coach Pero. You were once a student, a soldier of Coach Tab Baldwin in the Tall Blacks team for New Zealand, but then Coach Nacho Lizcano, a former Gilas Pilipinas consultant. You're here again in the Philippines for the World Hoops Clinic. Coach, you thought about the free offense and the ball screen defenses. What's that about?
Well, the first topic was the free offense, which it means that, in my opinion, and the way that I see it, is that the freedom that the player with the ball has when he takes the decisions. And then when he takes any decision, the rest of their teammates has mm-hmm. to know exactly where to go, exactly what to do, to have the right spacing, and everybody knows mm-hmm. at that time, even the players that are not playing, even the coaches, what is going to happen.
Mm-hmm. Is skill a big factor in that kind of offense?
It is not the greatest factor. Especially the passing is the skill that is more useful, okay. more than playing one-on-one, more mm-hmm. than any other one. Mm-hmm. Especially passing and shooting, mm-hmm. Because at the end what you try is to find an open shot, mm-hmm. coming from taking advantage at the beginning, accumulating advantage to find out the wide open mm-hmm. man.
Now, Coach Nacho, Coach Pero, I think you would agree that the global, you know, game of basketball is just really getting faster. The big man is, I hope, not getting too extinct, because you know about the fast-paced game of the NBA right now. But then it's really getting faster. How important, Coach Nacho, is defending quick ball screens? How important is it to be able to defend multiple types of offenses?
I mean, this is crucial, especially in a basketball in which teams don't allow easy layups, easy baskets, running fast breaks. Mm-hmm. So once you don't have that advantage, you have to play 5-on-5 situations. And in 5-on-5 situations, it is difficult to find an open shot because players are faster and are bigger, mm-hmm. so the space is less. So you have to manage to find a space. So it is very important to the spacing mm-hmm. and the way that you create advantages. Right now in the European basketball and the basketball all over the world, except maybe in the NBA, mm-hmm. Play the ball screen is one of the main things.
Yes, many things that the world really applies. But then, coaches, you've spent 3 days teaching the Filipino coaches on the international style of play. Coach Pero, what was it in Filipino, or what is it in Filipino coaches that you see great things in?
The way they play the game is very emotional, from the heart and their determination. You know, they are always punching above their weight, so to speak. They're fighting above their size. They're always the underdog, mm-hmm. and they are fighting. They have that spirit, you know, mm-hmm. that just keeps going and going and going. Mm-hmm. Skill-wise, they can shoot the ball very well, and they play up-tempo. Mm. You know? And I think their bigs play more like guards. So they're capable of shooting outside shot. They're capable of ripping and getting to the rim and creating for others. Mm-hmm. So I think they are more like five guards on the court, mm-hmm. more than big men. And, you know, the two guys are responsible for guarding the bigs. They do mm-hmm. a good job.
What about our coaches? Have you heard of any story about our, you know, Filipino coaches just really with that kind of desire?
I think just the passion with the coaches. You know, we had over 200 coaches register and come. And I think, you know, there was a story about a coach that come from Babuyan Islands, mm-hmm. which is up close to Taiwan, up yes. the tip. This is great. You mm-hmm. know, that's a long way mm-hmm. to come down to the World Clinic. And it shows there is drive and they care about, you know, their basketball up there. Mm-hmm. So it was good they came to learn. Mm-hmm. and just the passion that they keep showing, you know.
I agree. Mm. Coach Nacho, you've spent some time also in 2014 for the national team. Mm-hmm. Is there anything in the Filipino culture or maybe Filipino style of play that you can maybe take home to Spain?
Of course, because they play so different than we used to do in Europe, which sometimes is, or especially in that tournament, was crucial for us because most of the teams in FIBA world are used to play similar. Anguilas played different than the rest of them, so that's why I think that we had so much impact there and we were able to compete with everybody. So maybe in the future, now is everybody is playing more or less the same style.
Yeah.
So in the future we have to find out another way to play, and Gilas play different, so we have to learn to how to play different, and why not to copy some things that could be good fit in the other basketball.
And coaches, that is the beauty of the game, how really it evolves, you know, throughout the years, you said, Coach Nacho. But then one last question, Coach Pero, because amateur basketball season is starting in the Philippines, how do you think this was of a big help, you know, this seminar to our coaches?
I think because all the coaches that came were high school or college or grade school, that they can use some of the styles and what they've learned and apply it to their schools and create a different way that maybe they're normally playing. Mm-hmm. Not too much, keep the style, but add different things on both defense and offense. Mm-hmm. You know, you must look for an edge every year. Mm-hmm. And coaches grow and grow and grow. Mm.
Yeah. And the coaches, it is a blessing for you guys to be here with us in the Philippines, for us, for the coaches, and for the players also to learn from you guys. But then, Coach Nacho, kindly thank our supporters and our fans for attending the clinic.
That's all we have for today, sport fans. You can follow me on Facebook.
No. You can just thank the supporters for the ones who do. You can just thank the coaches who are watching why they attended the clinic.
Just say thank you.
Yeah, just say thank you to the.
Thank you all of them because it was a great experience for. I hope for all of them. That's the. At least they tell us. They told us that way, and we had a great feedback from them.
Yeah.
And we are very grateful for being here and share our knowledge with them. We had a great experience.
Yes. And we all look forward for you guys to come back. I hope Coach Tab organizes another edition of like this so other coaches can also, you know, come in and learn more from a great basketball minds like you guys. Thank you so much, Coach Pero.
Thank you.
Coach Nacho, thank you so much for your time. And we hope to see you again. Thank you.
Cheers. Thank you.